Dear brothers and sisters,
خواهران و برادران عزیز.
So great to be with you all.
خیلی خوشحال هستم که امروز با شما هستم.
I have known Siamik for many years.
برادر سیامک رو خیلی ساله که میشناسم.
Both of our churches are being connected through VMC.
از طریق VMC کلیساهای ما با هم در ارتباط بوده.
And I am so pleased to see some familiar faces here.
من خیلی خوشحال هستم که بعضی از چهرهای آشنا رو میبینم امروز.
God bless you all.
خداوند به همتون برکت بده.
I came from China.
من چینی هستم.
Before I came to Canada, I was an atheist.
قبل از اینکه بیام کانادا من خدا رو قبول نداشتم.
I grew up in the countryside of China.
من توی قسمت حاشیه‌ای توی کشور چین به دنیا اومدم و بزرگ شدم.
My family background was Buddhism.
و خانواده من بودایی بودن.
My grandmother and my mother, they all believe in Buddhism.
مادر بزرگم و مادرم همشون بودا رو قبول داشتن و باور داشتن.
And for myself, I was an atheist.
ولی خودم هیچ چیز رو قبول نداشتم. کلا خدا رو باور نداشتم.
At that time, I only believe in science.
من اون موقع فقط به علم باور داشتم.
I finished my undergrad and graduate study in China.
من لیسانس و فوق لیسانسم رو توی چین گرفتم.
Before I came to Canada in 1994.
قبل از اینکه در سال 1994 بیام به کانادا.
I was a mathematician.
یک ریاضیدان بودم.
I work in the Chinese Academy of Science in Beijing.
من توی بیجین توی آکادمی ساینس چین اونجا کار میکردم.
In 1994, I came to Waterloo.
من در سال 1994 رفتم به واترلو.
To pursue my PhD study in mathematics.
و خواستم که دکترام رو در ریاضیات بگیرم.
It was there I became a believer.
و همونجا بود که من شروع کردم به دونستن و باور کردن راجع به عیسی مسیح.
When I was back in China.
وقتی که برگشتم به چین.
A lot of tragedies happened in my family.
خیلی اتفاقات بد توی خانواده‌ام افتاد.
My grandmother hanged herself on the third floor of my house.
مادر بزرگم خودش رو دار زده بود توی طبقه سوم خونم.
I was born in 1966.
من در سال 1966 به دنیا اومدم.
When I was about 5 or 6 years old,
وقتی 5-6 سالم بود,
my father poisoned himself.
پدرم سم خورد و خودش رو کشت.
So a lot of tragedies happened.
خیلی اتفاقات بدی جوری توی خانواده‌مون افتاد.
I kept asking one question.
همیشه این سوال رو من میپرسیدم.
Why life is so difficult?
چرا زندگی اینقدر سخته؟
Only after I came to Canada.
فقط وقتی که اومدم به کانادا.
When I got the chance to hear the gospel.
وقتی که موقعیت این رو پیدا کردم که خبر خوش عیسی مسیح رو بشنوم.
There was in 1996.
در سال 1996 بود.
At the end of August.
و آخرای ماه آگوست.
When my wife and I went to a retreat.
من و همسرم رفتیم به یه اردو.
Both of us at that time became believers.
و هر دومون اونجا به مسیح ایمان آوردیم.
At that time God opened my eyes.
همون موقع بود که خداوند چشمای من رو باز کرد.
I realized what a sinner I am.
و فهمیدم که چه آدم انسان گناهکاری هستم.
I know that I deserve hell.
و میدونستم که لیاقتم اینه که به جهنم برم.
But praise God by the blood of Jesus.
ولی جلال بر نام خداوند که با خون عیسی مسیح.
My sins could be forgiven.
گناهان من میتونه بخشیده بشه.
I cry out to the Lord Jesus.
و من گریه کردم و عیسی مسیح رو صدا کردم.
Lord save me, cleanse me.
و خداوند من رو نجات داد.
The day I became a believer,
همون روز من یک ایماندار شدم.
I also know that I'm going to be a pastor.
و فهمیدم که قراره یک کشیش بشم.
Because finally I have found the way.
چون که بالاخره من راهم رو پیدا کردم.
I have found the truth and the life.
من بالاخره حقیقت رو و زندگی رو پیدا کردم.
There is in Jesus Christ.
که در عیسی مسیح بود.
The day I became a believer.
همون روز من ایماندار شدم.
I experienced that kind of love from God.
و تجربه کردم اون عشقی رو و اون محبتی رو که خداوند برای من داشت.
When I was young, because my father was gone.
وقتی که جوان بودم خب پدر نداشتم، پدرم مرده بود.
I was so envious when other friends they called their father.
خیلی ناراحت می‌شدم وقتی می‌دیدم بقیه پدراشو رو صدا می‌کردن.
So the day when I became a believer.
ولی اونجا وقتی که من باور کردم عیسی مسیح رو.
When I opened my mouth to pray.
وقتی که زبونم رو به دعا کردم باز کردم.
My Father in heaven.
گفتم پدر من که در آسمان هستی.
There has brought so much happiness in my life.
همون جمله خیلی شادی ها رو به زندگی من آورد.
Praise God.
جلال به نام خداوند.
So today I'm going to share from the Bible.
پس امروز میخوام از کتاب مقدس.
About father's heart turning to children.
راجع به قلب یک پدر که به سمت بچه‌هاش میره صحبت
کنم. There are three Bible sessions in the Bible in the scripture.
میخوام سه قسمت از کتاب مقدس رو بخونیم.
The first one is 1 Corinthians 4:15.
اولش اول قرنتیان 4:15 است.
Yeah, we are going to read this together.
با هم اینو میخونیم.
So our sister is going to read in your language.
من الان میخونم به زبان فارسی.
1 Corinthians 4:15.
که عیسی خداوند و انبیای خود را کشتند و بر ما جفا کردند و ایشان ناپسند خدا هستند و مخالف جمعی مردم.
The second passage is from Malachi 4:6.
از دومی از ملاکی باب 4 آیه 6 است.
Malachi 4:6.
و او دل پدران را به سوی پسران و دل پسران را به سوی پدران خواهد برگردانید. مبادا بیایم و زمین را به لعنت بزنم.
The third passage is from 1 Thessalonians 2:11.
بعدش از اول تسالونیکیان 2:11 است.
2:12.
11 چنان که می‌دانید که هر یکی از شما را چون پدر فرزندان خود را نصیحت و دلداری می‌نمودیم و وصیت می‌کردیم که رفتار بکنید به طور شایسته خدایی که شما را به ملکوت و جلال خود می‌خواند.
In 1 Corinthians 4:15.
در اول قرنتیان 4:15.
Paul mentioned there are many instructors but not many fathers.
پولس میگه که خیلی معلم‌ها میتونن باشن ولی پدرهای زیادی نیستن.
There are thousands of teachers.
خیلی هزاران هزار معلم میتونه وجود داشته باشه.
But there are not many fathers.
ولی پدرها زیاد نیستن.
Based on Malachi 4:6.
توی ملاکی 4:6.
If fathers are not turning to their children.
میگه که از وقتی که پدرها به سمت فرزندانشون برنمیگردن.
We will see curses all over the world.
میبینیم که لعنت ها بر کل دنیا و زمین واقع شده.
So it is so important.
پس این خیلی مهمه.
For fathers turning their hearts to their children.
که پدرها قلبشون رو به سمت فرزندانشون بیارن بچرخن.
I have a 10 year old son.
من یک پسر 10 ساله دارم.
When he was about 1 year old,
وقتی که حدود یک سالش بود,
he was growing his teeth.
داشت دندونش در میومد.
As parents, we know that.
به عنوان پدر و مادر شما اینو میدونستیم.
When a child is growing his teeth,
که میدونستیم که چه زمانی بچه دندونش در میام.
He will bite on anything.
و در اون زمان اون میاد و همه چیز رو گاز میخواد بگیره.
One time I was holding my son. All of a sudden, he bit my ear. It was so painful. My tears almost came out. Praise God. Through his biting my ear, I realized what is the difference between a teacher and a father. If I were only a teacher, I would slap him in the face. I would give him a good lesson. And I would never hold him again. That's a teacher. But I am his father. He could bite me for free. Because I need to be cautious next time. But I still hold him. That's the difference between a father and a teacher. The Bible says there are so many teachers, but not many fathers. When fathers are not many, curses will come. Dear brothers and sisters, we know that this world has been cursed when we all came to Canada. What happened these past years? We know that even Canada is under a curse. So many people, they don't know whether they are male or female. There are so many different sexual genders. May God have mercy on us. All the people know that this world has a big problem. They are trying to find out what are the causes. Some say it's political reasons. Others say it's economic reasons. Some will say it could be environmental reasons. Dear brothers and sisters, the Bible tells us the reason. The fundamental reason. The most basic reason. Because fathers' hearts are not turning to children. And children's hearts are not turning to the father. In Exodus 25-6, the law says clearly, for I, the Lord your God, am a jealous God, punishing the children for the sin of their fathers to the third and fourth generation of those who hate me.
تنبیه کردن فرزندان برای گناه پدرهاشون برای سوم و جنریشن برای نسل‌های مختلف.
By showing love to a thousand generations of those who love me and keep my commandments.
برای اونهایی که از من متنفر هستند و برای اونهایی که احکام منو نگه می‌دارن برای نسل‌های چند نسل آینده و گذشته‌شون من رحمت هم بخوام.
When a father's heart is not turning to the children, so many curses will be upon this earth. In US, there are many big companies.
خیلی شرکت ها و کارخونه های بزرگی وجود دارن.
In order to do better business, they often would do different surveys.
برای اینکه بتونن راه‌های جدیدی رو برای کارشون پیدا کنن، بعضی وقتا یک روش‌های مختلفی دارن، مثلا از بقیه سوال می‌کنن، سری سوالا رو مطرح می‌کنن.
There's a telephone company in the States. They did one survey.
یک شرکت مخابراتی توی آمریکا بود که یه سری سوال‌ها رو اومد از مخاطبینش به مخاطبینش مطرح کرد.
They try to find out when is the best time to do business.
می‌خواستن بدونن که چه زمانی بهترین زمان برای انجام فعالیت‌های اقتصادی هست.
When they could find the highest calling volume in which day.
در چه روزی بیشترین مقدار تلفن‌ها رو دریافت می‌کنن.
And the result is this.
و جواب این بود.
They found on a Mother's Day the phone line is very busy.
فهمیدن که توی روز مادر خط خیلی مشغول هست.
That is one of the most busiest day through the whole year.
در کل سال روز مادر روزی بوده که بیشتر تلفن ها انجام می شده.
Bless you all the moms.
خدا به همه مادرها برکت بده.
We also found out on Father's Day.
همچنین اینو فهمیدن که توی روز پدر
It is business as usual.
خیلی همه چیز معموله.
Also for those restaurant.
و برای رستوران ها
They have found out if it's Mother's Day.
فهمیدن که اگر روز مادر باشه
You need to reserve the good restaurant in advance.
فهمیدن که خب خیلی ها میان بهترین رستوران ها رو برای اون روز از جلو رزرو میکنن.
If it's Father's Day,
اگر روز پدر باشه
No problem, come anytime.
هر وقت خواستیم بریم توی رستوران ها زیاد مهم نیست.
In the States, there are many companies printing cards, holiday cards, birthday cards.
توی آمریکا ما خیلی از شرکت ها رو کارخونه ها رو داریم که یه سری کارت های مخصوص برای جشن های مختلف اینا چاپ می‌کنن.
They also did a survey.
اونا هم یه همچین سوالی رو دوباره پرسیدن از مخاطبینشون.
They found out in two occasions the cars were being bought most.
فهمیدن که توی دو جشن فقط هست که این کارت ها بیشترین خریداری رو میشه.
One is Christmas Day, the other is Mother's Day.
روز کریسمس و دومی هم روز مادر.
On First Day, business as usual.
روز پدر خیلی همه چیز معمول عادی.
In the States, there was a jail.
توی آمریکا یک زندان بود.
1,700 young people were put there.
1,170 آدم جوان اونجا گذاشته شده بودن.
One fast day, a Christian organization donated a lot of beautiful cards for that prison.
یک مؤسسه خیلی مسیحی روز یه عالمه کارت های تبریک فقط داد به اون زندان.
The cards were so beautiful and elegant.
این کارت ها خیلی قشنگ و خیلی شکل و شمایل خوشگلی داشتن.
The prison decided they would sell it to the children.
و اون زندان تصمیم گرفت که اینو به بچه ها بفروشه.
To the young people.
به همون جوان ها.
$1 per car.
و گفتن که $1 پول هر کدوم از این.
They made the announcement in the prison.
و توی زندان اعلام کردن.
One week passed, two weeks passed.
یک هفته، دو هفته گذشت.
Not a single young person coming to buy the car.
حتی یک نفر از آدم جوان هم نیومد که یک کارت بخره.
Father's Day is, it was so near.
روز پدر خیلی نزدیک بود.
So the prison just changed the policy.
و اون زندان تصمیم گرفت کلا این قانون رو عوض کنه.
You don't need to pay even $1.
بهشون گفت که اصلا $1 هم نیاز نیست بدید.
Anyone can come and get it for free.
هر کسی که بخواد میتونه بیاد و این کارت رو به صورت مجانی ما بده.
Write a card to your father in the Father's Day.
و گفت که برای پدرتون برای روز پدر این کارشو بنویسید.
Dear brothers and sisters.
Nobody.
خواهر و برادران عزیز.
1700 young people.
1170 جوان.
Not a single person coming to get a card.
حتی یک نفر هم نیومد که یه کارت بخره.
What's the problem with the fathers?
مشکل با پدرها چیه؟
When a father's heart is not turning to his children.
وقتی که قلب پدر به سمت بچه‌هاش نیست.
Curses happen.
لعنت‌ها اتفاق میفته.
So dear brothers and sisters.
از خواهر برادران عزیز.
Malachi 4:6.
ملاکی 4:6.
Tells us that all fathers' hearts need turning to their children.
میگه که همه پدرها قلبشون به سمت بچه‌هاشون برخواهد گشت.
Malachi is the last book in Old Testament.
ملاکی آخرین کتاب در عهد عتیقه.
Chapter 4 is the last chapter of Malachi.
و باب 4 هم آخرین بابیه که
Verse 6 is the last verse in that chapter.
و آیه 6 هم آخرین آیه توی اون باب هست.
The whole Old Testament ends with this verse.
کل عهد عتیق با این جمله تموم میشه.
If a father's heart is not turning to their children.
اگه قلب پدرها به سمت بچه‌هاشون برنگرده.
If a child's heart is not turning to the father.
اگه قلب بچه‌ها به سمت پدرهاشون برنگرده.
Curses will happen.
لعنت‌ها اتفاق می‌افته.
Praise God, we have a father in heaven.
جلال بر نام خداوند که ما یک پدر در آسمان داریم.
In Luke chapter 15.
در لوقا باب 15.
He not only talks about the prodigal son.
فقط راجع به پسر گم شده صحبت نمی‌کنه.
He more talks about the father of the prodigal son.
بیشتر راجع به پدر اون پسر گم شده صحبت می‌کنه.
This father in heaven.
پدری که در آسمان ما داریم.
Who really turns his heart to the child.
قلبش رو به سمت فرزند
برمی‌گرده. His heart is not turning to money.
قلبش به سمت پول نیست.
His heart is not even turning to his son's misbehavior.
حتی قلبش به سمت اشتباهات بچه‌اش، کارهای اشتباهی که انجام داده نیست.
His heart is not even on his own face.
حتی قلبش به سمت خودش نیست.
In Toronto downtown.
توی دانتان تورنتو.
There are many Chinese there.
خیلی آدم‌ها چینی هستند.
There's a Chinatown there.
و یک شهر کوچیک چینی.
More than 10 years ago.
10 سال پیش.
There were already more than 20,000 Chinese in downtown area.
بیشتر از 20,000 تا چینی توی قسمت دانتان تورنتو بوده.
At that time, many people came here in an illegal way.
اون موقع خیلی از آدم‌ها به صورت غیرقانونی می‌اومدن.
They spent a lot of money.
و خیلی هم پول خرج می‌کردن.
And used illegal channels to come to Canada.
و از طریق راه‌های غیرقانونی می‌اومدن به کانادا.
And one young person also came.
یک آدم جوان هم اومد.
And he worked very hard.
خیلی سخت کار کرد.
Tried to earn a lot of money.
و سعی کرد که خیلی پول در بیاره.
To pay back all the money he borrowed from relatives in China.
که بتونه اون قرضایی رو که از فامیلش تو چین گرفته رو پس بده.
And he also would like to really build a big house back in China.
و خیلی دلش می‌خواست که یه خونه خیلی بزرگ چین درست کنه.
But he was lonely and he worked very hard.
ولی خب تنها بود و خیلی سخت کار کرد.
And he got sick.
ولی بعدش مریض شد.
He was really homesick.
و خیلی دلش برای خونش تنگ شد.
So he talked to the father.
پس با پدرش صحبت کرد.
Father, I really miss home.
و گفت که خیلی دلم برای خونه.
Now I'm sick here.
و الان احساس میکنم که اینجا مریض
هستم. I want to come back to home.
من میخوام برگردم خونه.
The father just told him.
و پدرش بهش گفت.
Don't come back.
برنگرد.
So many people they go to Canada.
خیلی انسان ها میان کشور کانادا.
They could earn money.
و اونجا میتونن پول در بیارن.
And they could build up the houses here.
و میتونن اینجا خونه درست کنن.
How dare you come back?
تو چجور جرأت میکنی همینجوری برگردی؟
What about the own money we owed?
پس اون همه پولی که ما قرض گرفتیم چی؟
Don't come back here.
اصلا برنگرد.
You come back, I will die.
اگه تو برگردی من میمیرم.
May God have mercy on us.
Amen.
خداوند رحمتش رو بر این زمین قرار بده.
Where is the father's heart?
قلب این پدر کجاست؟
To money or to your son?
به پول یا به فرزندشه؟
Praise our Father in heaven.
جلال بر نام خداوند مادر آسمان.
He is the father of that prodigal son.
اون همون پدر فرزند پسر گم شده است.
His heart is really turning to his son.
و قلبش برای فرزندش است.
There is a story of the in the Olympic Games.
یک داستان در بازی‌های المپیک است.
It's the testimony of a father and a son.
این یه شهادتی از یک پسر و یک پدر.
In 1924,
در سال 1924,
in the Olympic game,
در یه بازی المپیک,
there was a player. His name is called Bill Hemmings.
یک کسی بود که اونجا بازی میکرد.
Bill Hemmings.
Bill Hemmings.
He was the number one player in canoeing at that time. So if he went and attended that game, if everything goes smoothly, he would get the gold medal. But the when later on he found out, if he went to the Olympic game, he could probably missed his wife's giving birth to his son. His wife told him, "You could go because other relatives are with me."
زنش بهش گفت تو میتونی بری چون همه فامیلا الان اینجا پیش من هستن.
But Bill Hemmings, he made a decision.
ولی Bill Hemmings یک تصمیم گرفت.
He said many people they could win the gold medals.
خیلی گفت که خیلی از آدما میتونن این مدال طلا برنده بشن.
But my child only has one father.
ولی بچه من فقط یک پدر داره.
I need to be with him.
ولی من باید با اون باشم.
So he didn't go to attend that game. This is a father whose heart is turning to his son. After 28 years, in 1952, there was a player attending the Olympic game at that year. His name was Frank Hemmings. He's the son of Bill Hemmings. Father spent so much time with his son. Also training him to be a canoeing player.
و بهش آموزش داد که اونا یه قایقران خیلی ماهر بشه.
Frank Hemmings won the gold medal.
Frank Hemmings اون سال مدال طلا رو برنده شد.
Right after he got the gold medal.
بلافاصله بعد از اینکه اون مدال طلا رو برنده شد.
He sent a message to his father.
یک پیغام برای پدرش فرستاد.
Dear Dad.
عزیزم.
Thanks for waiting a lot for me to be born in 1924.
مرسی که منتظر من موندی که در سال 1924 به دنیا بیام.
I'm coming home with the gold medal that you used to have won.
من با همون مدال طلایی که تو باید برنده می‌شدی دارم میام خونه.
Father's heart turning to children.
قلب پدرانی که برای فرزندانشون هست.
Children's hearts turning to father.
و قلب فرزندانی که برای پدرمشون
blessings upon blessings
برکت ها
In 1 Thessalonians chapter 2. 1 Thessalonians chapter 2, verse 11. Paul here mentioned. For you know that we deal with each of you as a father deals with his own children. Encouraging, comforting, and urging you. Dear fathers, dear brothers. Based on what Paul says here. If you are a father, you need to encourage your children. You need to comfort your children. You need to urge your children as well. So are you really an encourager to your children? In this world, so many fathers, they never really encourage their children. In our Chinese culture, most of the fathers are very harsh on their children. There are more than 500,000 Chinese immigrants in GTA area. In the Chinese culture, we focus a lot on education. When new Chinese immigrants come into Canada, the first thing most parents would do is to find out where is the best school. So many parents focus so much on good education. There is one Chinese pastor. He one time shared about his story. When he was in junior high school, one day he was so happy. Because for the first time in his life, he got number 2 in his exam. He raced back home and tried to tell his father that he got number 2. So he was so excited to tell his father. His father looked at him. Only number 2? And you got so excited? What a shame! You didn't study well! How can you be happy for being number 2? That's the Chinese way of education. In their pastor's testimony, he said that was the only time he got number 2 in his exams. From that day on, he realized that no matter how hard I try, I could never please my father. I could never please this man. I give up. He could barely graduate from his junior high school. All of us need to be encouraged. Our children need our encouragement. As a father, are you really encouraging your children? Be a comforter. When your children need to be comforted, do they come to you? Dear fathers, when our children need to be comforted, do they naturally think about you? Or they have to go to someone else? Praise God, we have a God who really comforts us. In 2 Corinthians chapter 7 verse 6, the Bible says that God who comforts the downcast comforted us by the coming of Titus.
خداوندی که آرامش میده به همه اونهایی که به آرامش نیاز دارن و رها شدن توی دنیا.
After I became a believer,
وقتی که من یک باوردار شدم,
God gave me the burden in sharing the gospel with Chinese.
خداوندی مسئولیت رو به من داد که برم و خبر خوش رو به چینی ها برسونم.
So after I became a Christian for 8 months,
وقتی که 8 ماه بود که ایماندار شده بودم,
I went back to China in the countryside to preach the gospel.
من برگشتم چین و به هم روستای خودم که راجبه کتاب مقدس راجبه انجیل صحبت کنم.
At that time, I was a visa student.
اون موقع یک ویزا استودنت بودم, یعنی یک دانش آموزی که فقط برای درس خوندن میاد به کانادا و هر وقت دست هم باشه باید برگرده.
And the school gave me scholarship to study in Canada.
و مدرسه من به من پول تحصیل رو داده بود که برم به کانادا و تحصیل کنم.
It was enough for me to live and study here.
برام اون مقدار پول کافی بود که هم زندگی اینجا زندگی کنم هم درس بخونم.
But not much extra money.
ولی زیاد بی اضافه نمی بردم.
So I went back to China to share the gospel.
پس برگشتم به چین که راجبه عیسی مسیح و راجبه خبر خوش صحبت کنم.
Because I have left China already for several years.
چون اون موقع خیلی سال بود که چین رو ترک کرده بودم.
I thought with the money I brought back it should be enough.
فکر کردم که با اون پولی که برمیگردم برام کافی خواهد بود.
But the prices in China already increased a lot.
ولی خیلی مبلغ‌ها توی چین بالا رفته بود اون موقع.
So after I went back to China, I found out my money was not enough.
وقتی که رفتم به چین فهمیدم که پولی که با خودم دارم کافی نیست.
Also, my family relatives, they were quite against of what I was doing at that time. I did my graduate study in Beijing Normal University. After I finished my study there, I married my supervisor's daughter. So when my parents-in-law, they found out I no longer do math research, my father-in-law, he was very angry. He sent me an email.
یه ایمیل برای من فرستاد.
3 words.
3 کلمه.
You are crazy.
تو دیوونه.
So when I was in, went back to Beijing.
پس وقتی که به بیجینگ برگشتم.
He was very angry with me.
خیلی از دست من عصبانی بود.
And I didn't have enough money.
و پول کافی هم نداشتم.
So from Beijing to my hometown area in the countryside.
پس از بیجینگ تا اون روستایی که من به توش به دنیا اومدم و بزرگ شده بودم.
I was so depressed.
خیلی ناراحت بودم تو مسیر.
But praise God.
ولی جلال و نام خدا من.
At that time I met a woman from the countryside area.
همون موقع من یک خانومی رو از که از همون روستاهای اطراف بود ملاقات کردم.
I was sitting on a train going south. I didn't sleep and I didn't eat. I was very depressed. So when the woman came up to the train, when she found that I was reading a Bible, she was so excited. She didn't know where I came from.
نمیدونست که از کجا میام.
Or where I was going.
من نمیدونست به کجا میرم.
She didn't know that at all.
اصلا هیچی نمیدونست.
When she found that I was reading my Bible.
وقتی که فهمید که دارم کتاب مقدس میخونم.
She asked me several questions.
شروع کرد سوال کردن از من.
Young man, you believe in God?
گفت که شما به خدا شما خدا رو باور دارید.
You would like to serve God?
تو میخوای که خدا رو خدمت کنی؟
And I told her yes.
بعدش گفتم که بله.
And then she said to me.
بعدش به من گفت.
You will be blessed.
خداوند تو رو برکت میده.
Because at your young age you know how to follow the Lord.
چون که توی این سن کم تو خوب میدونی که چجوری دنبال خداوند بری و دنبالش کنی.
At that time my tears coming out of my eyes.
اون موقع واقعا اشکم از چشمام سرازیر شد.
The only thing I could thought of.
همون موقع چیزی که تنها چیزی که میتونستم بهش فکر کنم.
We have a God.
این بود که ما یه خداوند داریم.
Who really covers the downcast.
که کسایی رو که بقیه ترکشون کردن رو آرامی میبخشه.
So dear fathers.
پس پدرهای عزیز.
Are we really comforting our children?
آیا ما واقعا آرامی که باید بچه‌هامون بدیم رو میدیم بهشون؟
Do our children think that we are their comforters?
آیا بچه‌های ما فکر می‌کنن که ما کسایی هستیم که بهشون آرامی بدیم؟
In 1 Thessalonians chapter 2 verse 11.
در اول تسالونیکیان باب 2 آیه 11
Paul also tells us.
پولس هم به ما میگه.
That we need to urge our children as well.
ما باید برای جلو رفتن فرزندانمون رو تشویق کنیم.
There's a doubly translation.
این ترجمه داربی هست.
Urge is being translated as testify.
تشویق کردن و کمک کردن به اینجوری معنی شده که به شهادت دادن معنی شده.
As a father when you are at home. When you are at home, urge your child.
وقتی که توی خونه هستین فرزندانتون رو بلند کنی تشویق کنی.
You urge your children through testifying.
شما این تشویق رو میتونید انجام بدید وقتی که شهادت میدید.
We need ourselves to live out God's words.
ما خودمون نیاز داریم که با کلام خدا زندگی کنیم.
So that we can urge our children effectively.
پس که از اون طریق بتونیم فرزندانمون رو حمایت کنیم و تشویق کنیم.
There's a testimony of a sister.
این شهادتنامه یک خواهر هست.
She grew up in US.
که در آمریکا بزرگ شده.
In North Dakota. In the North Dakota state. In her testimony.
توی شهادتنامه‌اش.
She mentioned about how her parents urged her in the Lord.
میگه که چجوری پدر و مادرش رو تشویق کردن و بلند کردن در ایمانش به عیسی مسیح.
Every time his parents would use a Bible scripture to teach her.
This
family, they live in a farm. And beside the farm, there is a road.
که بغل این مزرعه یه جاده بود.
And there are no other houses nearby.
و هیچ خونه دیگه‌ای هم اون اطراف نبود.
So often times when a car is broken down, someone would knock on their door.
پس چند وقتی بار هر وقت ماشین از اون قسمت رد می‌شده، یه نفر می‌اومد در خونه‌شون رو می‌زد.
So this family who host many strangers.
پس این خانواده در اصل میزبان خیلی از غریبه‌هایی که از اون ناحیه رد می‌شدن بوده.
One winter evening, there was a big snow.
یک روز غروب زمستون که خیلی هم برف باریده بود.
So there was a knock on the door.
کسی در خونه‌شون رو زد.
A family came in. They need help.
یک خانواده اومدن تو که به کمک نیاز داشتن.
So the parents they emptied their bedroom for that group of strangers.
و اون پدر و مادر اومدن یکی از اتاق‌هاشون رو خالی کردن برای اون چند تا غریبه که وارد خونه‌شون شده بودن.
And the second morning, the mom prepared a big feast for those strangers.
و صبح بعدم مادر اون خانواده یک جشن خیلی بزرگی رو یک غذای خیلی خوبی رو آماده کرد برای اون غریبه ها.
And when the daughter was not happy with what her parents were doing,
ولی دختر و خانواده زیاد خوشحال نبود با این کاری که خانواده‌اش داشتن انجام میدادن.
The mom didn't say much.
مادرش زیاد چیزی نگفت.
She just mentioned to her.
فقط بهش گفت.
Matthew 25:14.
گفت متا باب 25 آیه 14.
So the daughter went back to her room and checked out the Bible.
پس اون دختر رفت اتاقش برگشت و شروع کرد دنبال همین آیه‌ای که مادرش گفته بود گشت.
Jesus said, "Truly I tell you, whatever you did for one of the least of these brothers and sisters of mine, you did for me."
خداوند گفته هر چیز کوچیکی رو که برای هر کدوم از این خواهر برادرای کوچیک انجام بدید، دست برای من انجام دادید.
There was another occasion. When the father was working on the farm. It was in the fall season. And the temperature was going down. When the father saw there was a person walking on the road, didn't wear much.
پدر دید که یک کسی داره توی اون جاده راه میره و لباس گرم هم تنش نیست.
Father just took off his jacket for that person to wear.
اون پدر لباس خودش رو جاکت خودش رو در آورد و داد به همون شخص.
And the father went back home to take another jacket which is much worn out to wear on himself.
خودش رفت برگشت خونه که یه جاکتی که خیلی هم پهنه بود و برداره و خودش بپوشه.
When the daughter saw it, he was unhappy. Father just told her. Luke 3:11. Anyone who has two shirts should share with the one who has none.
هر کسی که دو تا لباس داره یکیشو باید به کسی که نداره بده.
There was another time.
یک زمان دیگه
Father was hosting homeless people.
اون خانواده میزبان یک گروه آدمای بی خانمان بود.
Their homeless person he was so hungry.
اون شخص بی خانمان خیلی گرسنه بود.
So father just prepared some food for him and for all the family.
پس پدر اون خانواده یه ذره غذا برای اون شخص
The family only got 4 eggs left. Father fried the eggs for all the family and the homeless. But that person was so hungry. When dad put those eggs on the table,
وقتی که اون تخم مرغ روی میز گذاشت پدره
he ate them all.
همشو خورد.
So So the daughter was looking at that person. In a very disgusting way. Father just brought her to her side. And just told her. John 21:17. She went back home, checked out the Bible. Feed my sheep. In her testimony, she mentioned there was one Bible verse which is her most favorite Bible verse. It was the Ecclesiastes 11, verse 1. One time there was a family, their car was broken down. They came to their house asking for help. Father and brother, they went out to fix the car. Mother was at home taking care of that group of people. The daughter was so anxious that they could leave as soon as possible. Because their family has a very naughty boy. Playing around in their house, causing a lot of mess. So she could not wait their family to go. Mom didn't say much, just told her. Ecclesiastes chapter 11, verse 1. She went back home, went back to her room and checked out the Bible. She could not understand. What does that mean? Are this family going to come back? Praise God. From that time on, any time when their family drove through on that road, they will make a stop. They will come in and have a chat. Every time their daughter, she was not happy. Because of that naughty boy. But praise God. After so many years, that daughter says that Ecclesiastes 11:1 was her most favorite Bible verse. After that boy grew up, he became her husband. Cast thy bread upon the waters. Cast thy bread upon the waters. For thou shalt find it after many days. A father's heart needs to turn to his children. Blessings upon blessings. May God bless all of us. Thank you for that.